Shenyang is a city located in the northeast of China. It is an important industry city in China and the largest city in the northeast. This famous historical and cultural city with 7,200 years of civilization history and 2,300 years of city building history, created by the dazzling Qing Chen period culture, Ming Dynasty culture, and the model industry culture in the history of Chinese culture. The world culture heritage, one palace and two tomb. Reappearing the grand scenes of the birthplace of one dynasty and the capital of two generations of emperors.
We can see the entire city is becoming better and it is very different from a few months ago. For me, I'm a half native of Shenyang. I have not lived here for more than 6 years. With the continuous development of China, Shenyang is indeed changed a lot. And it is quite different from what I remember. So today I'm also discover this city with you. Also, there is my good friend who is exploring the city with me today, and her name is Jiang. Let's welcome her together.
大家好，我是江思明月，是沈阳工程学院的学生。今天我会和王瑶一起来带你们探索沈阳。
Here, that is why it has become the popular fashion street. You can buy whatever you want, and there are high-end shopping malls and also cheap shops.
To be honest, Zhongjian is not an attraction. It is a good place for people in Shenyang to go shopping. But judging from the appearance of Zhongjian today, you can completely regard it as an attraction. Before you enter the shopping mall, you need to measure the temperature. You can go shopping, see and play around, and you will not incur any cost of this. We are now seeing Zhongjian is renovations. Its purpose is to make this place more culturally. Jiang, do you have any suggestions when people come to Zhongjie?
吃东西我建议去胡同，你可以花很少价钱买到美味的食物，就是这里。因为现在是工作日，所以人并不是很多，周末的话是需要排队的。来Zhongjie购物的话，年轻人更喜欢去地下商场，那里的衣服很便宜。
After a brief understanding of Zhongjie, the place we are going now is Shenyang Imperial Palace.
Now, I'm in Shenyang Imperial Palace, and this is one of the two remaining Imperial Palace in China.
Now, we have entered the Shenyang Imperial Palace. When someone mentions Forbidden City, they will think of Beijing, but there is also one in Shenyang, which was the palace of the earlier Qing Dynasty. According to the construction time and layout, the building of Shenyang Imperial Palace can be divided into three parts: East Road, Middle Road, and West Road. The Da Zheng Hall was constructed after Nur Hajj moved to the capital to Shenyang. It served as the place where the emperor stayed in the ceremonies and where lawyers of the eight banners discussed political issues.
This is Dajun Hall. The eight pillars inside are all made by wood, and the wood is come from the Changbai Mountain. Many places are locked. This is to protect the important cultural relics.
When we were in Shenyang Imperial Palace, it was being renovated. The Shenyang Imperial Palace has a history of more than 140 years. Among the remains of the ancient buildings in the country, it is known for its strong Manchu characteristics. It is well known at home and abroad.
And this is a small area of Shenyang Imperial Palace to put the painting and seven category cop-like running script.
During the visit, we are lucky to meet two support staff and interview them about what they feel after visiting the Shenyang Imperial Palace.
我是来沈阳这边支援的，就从外地过来。
那您逛完了整个故宫之后，您对故宫有什么的想法或者是感慨呢？
因为之前我们也是在北京去支援了一次，在6月底的时候。 然后就当时是想去北京故宫博物院，但是因为疫情原因嘛，我没去成。然后这次来沈阳博物馆的话，就可以觉得弥补一下上次的遗憾。虽然没有故宫博物院那么大壮观，但是其实相对来说还是比较满意的了。那这位先生，你有什么想法呢？或者是感慨呢？
我也是去过北京，然后因为第一次去的时候预约，然后没预约上。 然后来这边的时候，其实也是，其实历史没有特别好，其实来这边也是边看边学的，就一直边了解，我觉得挺有意思的，就来到这边，我觉得感受一下古代的建筑，还有一些，就感受一下原来的一些人情风土人情之类的，还是蛮不错的，觉得。
There are 33 pieces of Qin pilots, clocks, and watches in the exhibition, among which are fine products produced in British, French, Switzerland, and other places.
After visit Shenyang Imperial Palace, this place really impressed me. These places are full with historical and it is very important cultural palace of China.
Beiling Park is the largest park in Shenyang. It is also a national key park. It is located in the north of Shenyang, and it was originally the royal tomb. The Beiling Park is also called Zhao Mausoleum. It is composed of three parts, the front, the middle, and the back, from south to north. The Zhao Mausoleum in the Beiling Park is the tomb of Emperor Huang Taiji, the second founding monarch of Qing Dynasty, and his empress Xiao Duanwen. On the east and west sides of the main road at the main entrance, there are many gardens. Here, nearly 200 kinds of plants have been planted. The citizens will watch and take photos here. In Beiling Park, there are many slow walking teams who come to Beiling for activities every night. On a rainy day, Beiling seems really quiet. You can feel peace here. The Zhao Mausoleum of Qing Dynasty is one of the historical sites in Shenyang. The essence of ancient Chinese architecture and a typical culturally exchange between Han, Manchu, and Mongolia.
Now I'm inside the Beiling Park. Behind me is Taiji Square. We can see that there are many people in Beiling Park. So this is a very good place for family to come. And it will be free before 6 a.m. and after 6 p.m. every day. Okay, we can see now it's behind me. There are many areas for people to dancing, jogging, and playing. And inside the Beiling Park, there are many people. They have a group. They can be joined together. And this is the healthy life in Shenyang.
When we visiting Beiling Park, we also interviewed two local young people.
我想请问一下，今天你是自己一个人来的吗？啊，是，晚上吃完饭自己来跑跑步。我想请问你一下，在你心中，北陵公园是什么样的？嗯，我觉得北陵吧，是沈阳历史文化的一个代表。然后呢，这边空气什么的也不错，哎，人也挺多，晚上来溜达溜达挺好，也挺热闹的。
你好，我想请问一下，您经常来到北陵公园吗？是的，每天晚上吃完饭之后都会来这里散散步，看看这些的风景，看看这些在广场上活动的人群，感觉每天都挺开心的。我想请问你一下，如果其他人来到沈阳的话，您会建议他们来北陵公园吗？我当然会建议他们来啊，这里的环境是非常优美，而且人们都很想喜欢这里，人们也很和善，而且这个公园对于沈阳的历史意义也非常重大。 它是中国第一个在沈阳来这里建都的一个地方，所以说我很建议大家来这里参观。
Now already 8:30, I really hope you enjoy the training with me today. This city with full historical, and this is Shenyang, a northeastern city of China.